Yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is video.
Everybody lip sync to something.
So I came out on August 10th. I left church. August 10th was the last time I went to church, actually.
Poetry, and I just started reciting it. And basically, that's just how I started doing what I did. I just came out, and the people was like, this is what they need to see. They need to see the youth doing something positive, something good.
It was very emotional to see, like, the body just laid out there. I actually got to see the body before they covered it. They covered it, I forgot how many hours he laid out there, then they finally covered it. And it was just chaotic, like everybody was outside. I didn't expect it to get as big as it did. They picked him up in a black SUV, and the way they just treated him was just like a dog.
I never hid my background, so the world know my background. So when I hear something like that, it's just like, I brush it off like, you know, somebody else got killed. But he started telling me, it was like it was the police. And I started looking at all the tweets of what people were saying, and I seen a picture somebody took from their window, and his body was just laid in the middle of the street, with blood everywhere. And I just kind of lost it. You know, I just felt like hot tears coming down my face, and it was just like enough was enough. I was just tired.
Real honest conversations about it. The Democratic Party don't really give a fuck about black people.
Yeah. And our black president is black. He's also the first $1 billion president. He had to spend $1 billion to get elected, and people pay $1 billion to put him in that office.
Second verse, I'm gonna tell you how my life is.
People would talk about all the time, like, oh, I share so much on my Facebook, and they're like, oh, I don't wanna hear about it. I'm like, well, you get to just unfriend me. You know what I mean? People in Ferguson, y'all don't get to just like unfriend racism.
There you go. It's the exodus, no fiend for milk and honey, but money and stretching. Shrieking from all the blood and the swine of an evil plot over here, and the team of shots and praying about to stop.
Looks like by now, you got to know, there's no chance to beat Hitler by protecting Jim Crow.
This stage is both sanctuary and emergency room. My people are both Rios and doctors.
And I hear, whoop, whoop, get off your bike, sir.
So I do what any man of color would do in this moment in time. I pretended to be a white woman. I was like, what happened, officer?
Yeah.